Oh, I don't know when the stream went out, guys. Hang on. I just noticed the stream went out. Let me see if I can... Yeah, it says, I'm live now. I don't know. Can someone chime in and tell me when the stream cut out? Because I just noticed it when I was in the middle of hole seven. Yeah, seven. And I don't know what the last thing you guys saw was. But my drive on hole six sucked, and I ended up hitting the rough. I barely clipped the rough and went into the bunker right here, and I had to make this recovery shot. I'm just gonna kind of go over the last two holes. Yeah, and if I would have hit perfect, I probably would have missed that, so that great ball actually ended up helping me. And then, hole seven, I took a new approach and actually almost aced it. I was pretty close. I think I overcurled it a little bit. Or I over-adjust. Actually, I think I over-adjusted it. That looks like the problem. Because I kind of just eyeballed that one. Yeah, because I hit too far right there. Yeah. And I needed to come up more on that hill. And I didn't come onto the green with enough speed. But it was still really close. Okay, now going into hole eight. I'm gonna use the APOC here, because the ball guide doesn't really help me like I was thinking, as much as I was planning it to. Gonna put the Malibu in, just in case. I feel more comfortable using the Malibu over the Spitfire. Man, this round is not meeting my expectations. You can still clean it up and make some more happen, though. Still a lot of holes to play. I think I'm going to play this about the same way I've been playing it. Or wait, no, it's more of a side wind than this, I forgot. I'm not sure how much I should adjust, actually. I know I need to hit close to the edge of the rough, though, because this will die in the rough. I'll adjust a little extra and we'll see. Like, it's an 8-mile-an-hour wind, I'll adjust, like, 9. And then I'll go off that and see. Here, I'll curl a little right, too. Hopefully I'm not over-adjusting this. It looks like I did. Yeah, I did over-adjust that. So, I'd say that's actually like a one-to-one adjustment. Because you're at min distance, but you're still having that elevation multiplier come into it. Like I said, I play them at 133%, and that seems to work for me. So if you're at min distance, let's say, and you have like a 10-mile-an-hour wind, and I'm just using 10 for ease of math, and then we play 75% at minimum distance, so that would be turned to a 7.5-mile-per-hour wind. But then if you factor in the elevation multiplier of 1.33, then you come back to a 10-mile-an-hour wind. That's why a lot of shots out in shootouts and stuff, when you're playing at min distance and you do the shot, it still seems to be affected fully by the wind, because there's two different factors in play, but they basically cancel each other out. So I actually don't have to use full topspin on that shot either. Alright, I'm glad I picked up that eagle. Just gotta remember that next time, only adjust 1-to-1 on this. Because for Master, well, Master we have a headwind too, and we're going into like max distance with Apex. My Apex 7, I'm going up to max distance almost. Oh, that sucks. Damn. That's brutal, man. I feel bad for that guy. Those are the worst to miss, when you do a really good shot and then you just choke on the putt and miss. Okay, hole 9. What's hole 9? Okay, I need the Spitfire in. Oh yeah, I don't need the hammerhead in. The sniper will work fine. And I just don't want to go too far up on this drive. What the hell? Oh wait, no, the stream's still going, okay. I thought the stream went out again. Yeah, that picture's so small and I noticed it on hole 7 or whatever that it wasn't there. Why is it in the middle? Get out of the way. Yeah, this shot plays at 133%, so for an 8-mile-an-hour wind, I'm going to use like 5 topspin here. Want to try and hit like close to the middle of the fairway. Yeah, for an 8-mile-an-hour wind, I'm going to play it like a 10, and I'll adjust like 10 and a half. I adjusted about 11 there, just to be a little safe. Don't want to curl too much right and curl into the bunker. I could have curled a little more, but that's the line I want. I want to be able to have room to curl a little right if I need to. You don't want to be having those trees block your line of sight. And I think I remember from my expert round and qualifier, I added a little bit of right curl and I missed right. So I might not be curling right this time. And just play it straight. And I used 1 topspin, I remember, and that was good. And this guy, I think, is playing a little close to that fairway. Oh, I think he might clip the rough. It's going to be close. Yep. Damn. Hopefully we can hit this and save him. Alright, how much room do I have? See, I have a little bit of space. Not a whole lot. But I might not need to curl, we'll see. I don't need to curl. I actually don't need the full right spin, I don't think. Here, I'll do 6 and see. Oh shit, running out of time. I hope I adjusted that enough. Yep. I missed left. Yep. I mean, that's still a tough elbow no matter what. I don't get why my stream's been cutting out lately. It's like, it always says the health is good and my internet's good, and then it happened yesterday too when I got to around 40 minutes or so, it just cut out, and that happened again today. I actually wonder if I played further up, if I went for the rough bump down there, if that would give me a better shot at the albatross. It's definitely a riskier shot. And I don't really know if the risk is worth the reward there. This guy's using too much topspin. And he didn't adjust enough. And he's gonna curl into the trees. That's why you don't curl left. Or curl right, because you'll go left into the trees. Okay. 13 front. I mean, it's not bad, but I really was expecting better. Okay, switching back to the rock for this next hole. Let's get something going here, guys. This time I won't be hurt.